Our motor needs quite a bit of help, as of course the wheels were deteriorated, but not only the wheels, but all the wiring that comes to our reversing unit and the wire that comes up from the bottom contact. I'm going to take the motor apart so I can get at the wiring and decide how best to either repair it or replace it. I mentioned that we could use some tubing if we chose, or just replace the wire in entirety. So let's see how easily the motor is going to come apart. Now, I showed you these wheels before and they kind of came off on their own, but the best way to take the wheels off of these old trains, if you can, the easiest way is to get a couple large flat bladed screwdrivers and just get them underneath one of these wheels and pry them off. And of course, these kind of came off on their own. So those are off. Pull off the wheels with the gears and set them aside. And when we re-wheel, then I'll show you more about how to deal with the gears. To take the motor apart, my best suggestion is we take the E-unit out. The E-unit is actually a separate unit mounted inside the motor frame. And if you look at this side of the motor plate, you'll see a number of screws. I'm going to take the screws on the bottom and I'm going to loosen them, because what I want to do with this plate down the bottom, the contactor, is I want to remove it so I can put in a new wire. So I've loosened those two screws and some of the screws that hold my E-unit in. This is one of them. I'm going to just take that out completely. And then what we need to do is remove the wires from the unit. Before you do that, you should note where the wires go. These two long wires on the bottom are the ones that go through to the brushes. So I'm going to take needle nose pliers and just back them out. And you notice the insulation is crumbling pretty badly. And that's those two. This is the wire that delivers the power from the pickup. And also, and as you can see, that's really bad. This is the wire that comes, one of the wires coming from the E-unit, and it can stay there. This is the wire from, this black wire, from the field coil. And we can take that off. And at this point, our E-unit comes out, and now we have a really, really sad looking bunch of wires. But in addition to our E-unit coming out, since we have the wheels off, we can now get our pickup out. And remember, another thing that we said we needed to do with our pickup is we needed to put a piece in here, just like on this side, to keep it from falling down too far. So what I'm going to do now, I may as well just replace this wire completely, and I can kind of get at the wires from the brushes, so I'll probably replace them. The wire from the field coil looks to be in decent shape, and this wire in the E-unit, it's probably easiest just to put some tubing over it. And before I put this back together, I'm going to clean. Our motor is now apart, and just to point out some of the various pieces we see, right in the foreground here are the two brushes, and I decided I'll deal with putting them back in to the brush retainers. Here's the brush retaining plate, one of the motor side plates, here's the other side plate, the armature, and the armature doesn't come out unless you remove the pinion gear. Here's our field coil, and over here in the distance is our reversing unit. I removed the old wires and the insulation, and the crud you see around my cardboard is the crumbled insulation from the old wires, which are thrown away. There's a little spacer on the end of this wire. This is the spacer that goes on the end of the commutator when I put it back together. Just so I don't lose them, I put the screws back where they belong, including in the E-unit. And I've cut off the wire, it's the pickup wire down here. I'm going to repair the pickup assembly by replacing these and put the motor back together. So I won't belabor you with all the details. There is quite a bit of soldering. If you're not adept at soldering, you might want to consider just sleeving the wires yourself. But in this case, I decided I'll just put new wires on and solder it. It should look better and work better and clean it up. Again, move on, and the next step will be a refurbished motor.